Hi, this is Sean Darrington, Senior Director of Product Management. In this short how-to video, I wanted to share with everybody the new two-factor authentication as an optional way to improve the security and control that OneSystem admins have within their organization to perform certain tasks, such as deleting shares, deleting a remote replication configuration, or in some cases, even resetting the OneBlox to factory default. Essentially, anything that might cause potential data loss for an organization. We've gone another step further, and in addition to what we've been doing for quite some time of having a strong password confirmation for the OneSystem admin to enter as a verification, we've added the option for now organizations to say, hey, I want another level and I want to use a one-time password through two-factor authentication. And so that's what this video is going to be. So let's get started. So I've already logged into my OneSystem account here, and you can see I have two different services. I'm admin for Dog Food Inc. We run OneBlox here in the office. And then also in my own service here, and this is just in a QA and test environment. So now under the login here in the top right, you see sean@exablox.com. There are two different settings here, and this is how you enable the two-factor authentication. First of all, I go into the admin setting, and here you can see that now two-step verification has not been configured. So I'm going to go ahead and click on configure this, and now I have the option to, number one, I have to enter in my password, and this is just the OneSystem password. So now that I have clicked on this, I have two options for the two-factor authentication. Number one, I can use a mobile application that runs on iPhone and Android as well as Windows. This uses Google Authenticator. There's no cost to do this. The second is I can select text messages, and this will actually send an SMS to your mobile phone, and this will work also internationally. And then for every one-time password, OneSystem will text message you a one-time password to use. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and use Google Authenticator. And what you'll see here is that after you download the app on your phone, you can go to the next step, and now there's a QR code. And this link here will actually open up a web page to actually download Google Authenticator for your particular mobile device. And you can see it just through the Google Play Store. At this point, I'm going to go back to OneSystem here. And now I can just, from my phone, scan this QR code. And now that generates a one-time password that I enter in here, and this is the first step of verification to associate Google Authenticator with your account. Now I've successfully done that. So now I click on OK, and now it takes me to the admin settings page. This is where now that I can decide for a different service or for a specific service I'm managing, I can either enable or disable two-factor authentication. Now, once you do this for the entire service, it's actually going to require all OneSystem admins in that service, included delegated admins, if you are working with a managed service provider, to use a one-time password for operations that may cause data loss. So now in this case, I'm gonna go and I'm going to show you just through the account settings. Once you have two-factor authentication enabled, this is the place where you have been able to change your password. Now we have an additional level of options here for enabling and changing your two-step verifications. This trusted devices, after you log in for the first time, when you are prompted for your username and password, you'll have the option to say trust this device. It'll actually trust that device. You don't have to enter your one-time password each time. But that's optional. I'm going to leave that disabled for now. So I'm going to actually return to the overall dashboard, and I'm going to go into my service here, Sean, and now you're going to see a couple of things here. This is an old ring that's in our QA system. This is the ring that I am currently managing. This is a three-node ring of OneBlox 4312. So now if I go into my shares and exports, I'll see I only have two shares created because this is just for test and demo purposes here. But here I have a share prepped for two-factor authentication delete. Now, when I actually want to delete this share, it's actually going to obviously delete all the primary information, but in this case, I have snapshots enabled, which you see down there at the bottom of the screen. It will also delete all the snapshots. And because this is something that will cause data loss, this can't be undone. It's going to prompt me now for my one-time password. Normally, you would see the prompt for your OneSystem password. In this case, because I have enabled two-factor authentication, now I have to enter in my six-digit code. 498, and now I have the option to verify this. So now the share is gone, and you see I only have the public share. Now, part of OneSystem is that we want to provide OneSystem admins the ability to audit and understand what has taken place throughout their organization. And so in the reporting tab here for my ring, I'm going to actually select my San Francisco ring. You have audit logs. You also have different charts for capacity. If you click on charts, you can actually see the historical deduplication ratio. But for the purposes of this how-to video, we're going to take a look at the audit log, because I wanted to show you that now I was logged in as myself as the admin. I deleted the ring or share on San Francisco in the share name of two-factor authentication, 2FA, underscore delete. And you can see the date and time that happened. So these are things that actually are logged as administration tasks that you can go back and look at historically, but it is something that we wanted to provide another level of security for organizations that want to control which admins have access to one system, but also who is actually securely managing that storage. Now, this is that two-factor authentication for the trusted computer I was mentioning earlier, in that when I log in, I enter in now my password, but because I've enabled two-step verification or two-factor authentication, I now have to enter in from my Google Authenticator app the one-time password, and I'm going to leave this unchecked again, and now that is how I actually log in. So if I didn't have my one-time password, I wouldn't be able to log in, and that's something that every organization can make the determination if they want to enable. So that's as easy as it is to actually enable two-factor authentication and use that for another level of security for one system administration. Thanks for watching.